Welcome to section 3 of Carbohydrates, Blood Glucose Regulation. I want to explain blood glucose regulation. I'm going to use this diagram. So first I'm just going to orient you. This is going to represent the bloodstream with these representing glucose as they have throughout this lecture series. Our liver, intestines, fat, muscle, and pancreas. They are obviously not in this order in the body, but this is just a diagram to help illustrate some of the concepts. So again, I'm gonna start with the bagel. And again, I like to use the white bagel because it is a perfect example of a very highly refined product. It is as mostly starch with just a little bit of protein and fiber, a few other nutrients, but is very easily digestible. And when you eat the bagel, and as it goes through the intestines, remember it goes from starch to the glucose change to maltose, very quickly digested, and ends up in the bloodstream as glucose. So when you eat a bagel or highly refined product, such as a bagel, the blood sugar goes up. Now, how does the body respond to this? Well, the pancreas is going to release insulin, and insulin is represented here with the I, and this insulin is released in response to high blood glucose. Now, insulin's role is to assist in the transport of glucose into the cells. Particularly the muscle cells and the fat cells. The glucose then leaves the bloodstream and goes into the cells. So as the glucose is leaving the bloodstream, all these glucose are now going to be going into the cells. It's going to bring the blood glucose back to a normal level. So the goal of insulin, our storage hormone, is bringing that energy in the form of carbohydrates, in the form of glucose, into the cell so it can be either utilized or stored. So insulin is a storage hormone. We like to think about it that way. So now we're back to a normal blood glucose. So let's think about the opposite. So instead of having your bagel for breakfast, maybe you skipped breakfast or you skipped a meal and you didn't eat. Well, how does the body deal with that if you're not eating? The body has a fantastic way of dealing with this. If you skip a meal, the blood sugar does go down. So now you don't have that form of energy, carbohydrate energy in your bloodstream for the cells to use. Blood sugar goes down. Now this is, of course, going to stimulate, make you a little lightheaded maybe, fatigued. You definitely will get a little bit get hungry. But your body can respond to this. You don't necessarily always have to eat right then because the pancreas is going to release glucagon. Glucagon is a hormone that's going to tell the liver to release glycogen. Now remember, glycogen is our storage form of glucose, our storage form of carbohydrates, mainly stored in the liver and the muscle. And the liver likes to share its glucose, share its glycogen. So once the glycogen is released, it will then break down, remember, into glucose. So what will that do? That is then released into the bloodstream, and we bring the blood sugar, the blood glucose levels, back to normal. So again, your body has a way of dealing with high blood sugars and low blood sugars to bring them back to normal. Now, if you're eating whole foods, and they're whole foods, high fiber, I say low sugar, but also low starch, low refined products, then you're going to have a slower absorption of glucose. So remember, we just went through the digestion and absorption process, but when you eat really refined products and sugars, they're going to go into the bloodstream very quickly. But if you have something with high fiber, also if you have a mix of whole foods with protein and fat, it's going to slow the absorption of glucose so you don't get that big spike of sugar in the bloodstream. So then you might, insulin and glucagon will still be working together, but it's not going to be these really high and really low spikes. Now let's go back to our bagel example. The bagel, high starch, it digests very quickly. It absorbs very quickly into the bloodstream. So you eat this bagel and boom, you have a bloodstream full of sugar. Well, the body's going to respond to that. It doesn't want that high of sugar. The pancreas releases insulin. So now the bloodstream is full of sugar and insulin, glucose and insulin, right? Well, what's insulin's job? It's a storage hormone. It's going to pull this sugar out of the bloodstream. It wants to get it back to a normal level. It wants to bring it into the muscle if it needs it for use, or it'll bring it into fat to be stored as fat. Remember, it's a storage hormone. So bagel, starch, those are glucose chains, maltose, glucose, high spike in your blood sugar, spike of insulin. Then the insulin works, drives the glucose out of the bloodstream, and leaves us with just a little tiny bit of sugar. Well, what does that do? Well, it makes you tired, makes you hungry, right? So then what happens? You eat the bagel and you feel high, you feel good, you always have the sugar buzz, because, right, it breaks down into glucose, which is our form of sugar, and then that sugar gets pulled out into the cells. You know, if you're sedentary, it's going to just be stored as fat, and then you drop back down again. So now you have that sugar low. Now you're tired. You're thinking, I'm hungry. So what do? You eat the bagel again. So now you're feeling good again for that little bit of time. And then again, you have that sugar low. So even though it's not sugar, it's still, I call it the sugar buzz, the sugar low, that feeling of tiredness and fatigue after eating. And it could be a lot of calories. So to avoid this sugar high or sugar buzz, sugar low, this is where I go back to what I've been saying throughout the whole semester, is the more refined products, the more processed the products are, the more sugar, the more added sugar, not naturally occurring added sugar in them, then the more likely you're going to be on this roller coaster ride. And when you're eating this food, you don't really need it. It's just going to be stored as fat because it's just the insulin is pulling it in to the fat cells. What is a better idea, just to go back to what I've been saying over and over again, is to eat more whole foods. And we talked about the package that the food comes in, or the sugar comes in, and as soon as you have it with fiber, it's going to slow that absorption of glucose. It's also going to give you added nutrients, and it's going to help keep this a little bit more normalized. And we'll talk a little bit about how fiber and sugar, which almost always occur together in nature. You never really have sugar alone, with the exception of maybe honey in nature. But having those together really will impact your blood glucose levels. And we'll talk about that next.